Everyone, it's been a while. You know, it's been a while since we've done an episode of Coffee and Metal because of this little thing called COVID that's been going around, apparently. So it halted everything, including black metal. I mean, including Coffee and Metal and our weekly updates. We were shooting at a studio in a company called Options for All. With the help of my lovely sister, and but since they closed down due to COVID, well, we have to also the studio shut down. So I fell into a little bit of a depression, you know, not really knowing what to do and feeling really weird about this whole situation. But you know, we gotta thrive on. And yeah, I admit that I fell a little bit off the track, and I could have done better with Coffee and Metal in this situation. I know the guys from Super Metal World never stopped. They've been going at it strong, interviewing people and whatnot. So more power to them. Shout out to Super Metal World for keeping the wheel of metal moving. And I got a little idea as to what to do with Coffee and Metal in this situation. But I'll get into that in a bit. First, I want to give a couple of shout outs. First of all, to Kristen, it's her birthday. It was her birthday, and I just want to give her a quick shout out. Much love to her. She's the correspondent of Coffee and Metal, if you don't know who she is, giving us a female perspective in and out of the metal world. You know, so she's pretty freaking awesome. Also, Alberto, our cameraman, has a new podcast. So if you're in the local scene in San Diego and you play guitar, please contact Alberto. Yeah. He's doing a podcast through Acid Tones. And yeah, so let me explain you what's going to happen. First of all, in Coffee and Metal, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give you like a quick roundup of the news in the metal world and in the world in general, because now we need it more than ever to stay updated on what's going on in our world. And then after that, I'm going to highlight a band. And every episode, I'm going to highlight a different band, a different local band, because, you know, big bands are okay, they're fine. What I noticed needs a lot of love right now, it's our local scene, you know, because they thrived in the local scene, and they lived off making shows, doing shows and touring around in our local circuit, you know. So now that bars are closed down, that became impossible, you know. So a lot of bands are relying on their band camps and merch and other ways to bring revenue through their artistic talents. And in Coffee and Metal, what we're going to do is we're going to highlight a band each week. So this is, I'm going to try to make this once a week. Once a week, we're going to highlight a different local band, and we're going to show a rerun of a performance and an interview we've done with said band. So this is gonna be all bands that we have worked with in the past, bands that we are really cool with, bands that we love to work with, and bands that we just would love to help out. I don't know if you can hear the dog, but you know that's gonna be a thing now. You know, you're gonna hear noises from the outside. I'm recording right next to a window, so you might hear crazy people since I live in a lively neighborhood. And yeah, so starting off with the news, the current news, there's a COVID thing, you know. The United States is number one in cases, because we looked at this as a political thing, you know. So for some reason, we thought that wearing a mask to you know, be considerate of other people meant that you supported a certain political party. So now it became this whole fucking situation. But let's remember that this affects all of us. You know, it doesn't matter what your where you stand in the political spectrum, this affects all of us. And it's an effort. And this effort that we put in together is going to help out bring back the local scene, the local music that we love so much and that we all miss. You know, we all miss going to shows to see our favorite bands. You know, not only local bands, also the big bands. All kinds of music got canceled, and it sucks. It sucks, you know. It sucks for us. It sucks for the fans. It sucks for the musicians. It sucks for the people running the places. So let's remember, be considerate, and keep wearing your mask. Wear your fucking mask, for God's sakes. It's not that much to ask. It's like I saw on a meme, you know, if Slipknot can wear a mask for and perform for 2 hours, you can wear your mask on a Target to on a trip to Target. So, you know, it's not that big of a deal. I wear one while doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and it's fine, you know. Some people try to give me shit for it, but, you know. Anyway, let's move on to our featured band of the week. It's going to be a band that is really close to my heart. Tzimani. We're going to highlight Tzimani this week. And I'm actually wearing the shirt, yeah. They were kind enough to give me this shirt when we did the metal yoga together. We have worked with Tzimani on the past on several occasions. We cover their shows. We have worked with them on, like I said, on metal yoga, which was really fun. That's where they gave me the shirt. And whenever I see them at the metal swap meet and they walk by the booth or we walk by their booth, like, we just have to stop and say hi to each other because, you know, these guys are total class acts. And Eddie and Sebastian, they're just like, they're amazing guys, they're amazing musicians, and they are creating something unique that combines both the old school and the new school of heavy metal. So I really appreciate everything they do, and we're gonna highlight their performance right here in Coffee and Metal. And yeah, if you hear the squeaking, it's my chair. So anyway, we are going to relive that day that we met Tzimani. Actually, we've interviewed them a couple of times, I believe, and we've covered a couple of their performances, but we are going to relive the day that we met them at the local Race of Chaos in the Brick by Brick. This was on it was like 3 years ago already. My God, time flies by. And they're going to be accompanied by the performance of one of my favorite songs, Get Me Out of Here. So here is the interview and performance of one of our favorite local bands, local talents, Tzimani. Enjoy.
Hey guys, this is Chris from Coffee and Metal, and I'm here with Tzimani on their debut show. Guys, would you like to introduce yourselves and what you play?
I'm Eddie from Tzimani. I sing and play lead guitar and rhythm guitar, and yeah.
I'm Sebastian. I'm the drummer.
Now, guys, this was your debut show. How does it feel to play at the legendary Brick by Brick for the first time?
Oh, it feels really good. It's not our first time, but it's the first time back this year for more than a year of not playing, so it's just awesome to be back, be on stage, rocking out. There's nothing like it, man. This is like the best stage in San Diego, so it's always great to come out here, bring our friends, play a good show, and rock out and have a good time.
Yeah, you guys totally killed it. You know, you guys just finished your set. It was freaking awesome. You know, what I like about your sound, you guys, is that you have like this very classic heavy metal sound to it, you know, but it also like rejuvenates it, and it brings out this new energy that feels fresh. So
yeah, man.
What was like your influences to bring that sound to Tzimani?
You know, like, there's a lot of influence. I mean, growing up, you know, I remember when I was 12 or 13, this guy came home with Iron Maiden's first record.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So that was like our first step into Iron Maiden. So like, you know, just over the years, you kind of listen to different metals and different genres of metals. But like, you kind of, there was always something that spoke to us, especially for him when he was writing music, you know, like, so I would say like Iron Maiden definitely. And there's like the more modern stuff too, like Dream Theater.
Motley Crue, Guns N' Roses.
Yeah.
All hard rock bands. AC/DC, I don't know if it's in there, but you know, who doesn't love AC/DC, right?
Who doesn't fucking love AC/DC?
Yeah.
Now, you guys got a new video out. What's it called?
Final, right. No, Final
yep.
Hour.
Final Hour, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Sorry. You can edit that out, that'd be great.
And your first video, it came out how long ago?
Came out
about a month ago, actually.
Okay, so it's
so Get Me Out of Here was about a month ago, and then we did Final Hour last Friday.
Yeah.
So what are the future plans for the band? You know, is there an album coming out, an EP, something?
Yeah, so we're going to be heading into the studio soon. We're going to be recording our debut EP, and we're really excited about it. We're hoping to get it out sometime late fall or early fall. Late summer.
Around September.
Yeah.
Any details on it, like the name of the EP, the title?
Oh, no, we're still working all that stuff out.
Okay, there's five songs.
Okay, cool.
There's five songs. You've heard two.
Yes.
That we published as singles. So, but there's definitely five songs. It's going to be pretty rounded, you know. There's going to have a lot of the classic stuff.
Sweet.
Kind of like the Iron. There's a lot of, like, leads in there, you know. a lot of fast stuff too, you know, just kind of a little bit of everything, you know. Did you check it out?
Yeah.
From what you've heard, it's going to be something like that, you know.
So. Nice. So any tour dates, anything coming up, guys?
Yeah, we got some shows lined up in LA and Sacramento in September.
Friday, September 22nd, we have a show in Sacramento.
Cool.
And then that Saturday, we have a show in LA. So we're going to try to like book a tour around those dates. Maybe we could do like 5, 10, 15 dates, you know.
Yeah,
cool.
Start from there, and maybe we could work a tour schedule around there.
All right, so, you know, for people that want to find more about your awesome band, like, where do we find you guys? You know, where do we find your merch, your music? Where do we find all of you, all about you guys?
Our merch is on tzimani.bandcamp.com.
Cool, Bandcamp.
You can find us on any social media site.
Facebook.com/TzimaniOfficial. That's the same thing for Instagram, Tzimani_official. Then we got ReverbNation.com/Twitter.
Yeah. We got Reverb Nation. We have a Tumblr. Hell, we even have a MySpace, you know, if you want to go that far back.
If you go to just Tzimani.com.
Still exists?
Yeah. If you go to Tzimani.com, you can click on all the different links to follow us everywhere.
Sweet. So, awesome. All right. So, you know, this is a band you guys need to keep your eye on, and we'll keep an eye on them. So, this is Chris for Coffee and Metal. We'll see you next time. Yeah! Yeah.
was the interview and performance of Tzimani. As you can see, we're really excited to see him. If I look really sweaty, it's because I closed my window and it's San Diego. It's freaking hot right now, so excuse the sweatiness. But yeah, that's Tzimani, and in the description, we're gonna leave the link to their Bandcam, their website, if we could, any upcoming tours. But yeah, we hope to hear from them pretty soon. And if you're a band and you want to get highlighted in this new weekly update in this new world, please give us a shout out. We are gonna try to go down through we're gonna go through all the bands that we work with, which is quite a number. That way we keep releasing content constantly and bands keep getting attention, and because that's what Coffee and Metal has always been about, to give the attention to the bands. And yeah, so if you're a band and we work with you, or we haven't worked with you and you still want a shout out, let us know. These are difficult times. Wear your fucking mask. There are bands that are making masks from their own bands, like Warpath has now Warpath masks, so support your bands, buy their merch, support Tzimani and other metal stuff that you see. For example, I've been staying sane with this True Cold Coffee. They have never left our side, even though we were inactive for a while. True Cold Coffee still stay by our side. Support them, support Super Metal World, support Tzimani, support your local bands, even though they're not playing right now. And for God's sakes, wear your fucking mask. And yeah, so this is the first episode of this thing that we're doing. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see how it evolves. Maybe we can have some Zoom guests. And I don't know, in this crazy new world. Anyway, remember to drink your coffee and keep it metal.